So in a couple of weeks, we will be putting the buoys out. So we're going to start preparing them for deployment. Some of the things that I have to do before we are ready to deploy is go through all the mooring equipment from last year, make sure I don't have any broken shackles, broken chain. Technical stuff-wise, there's a lot of electrical components that we have to make sure are working correctly, so a variety of sensors that need to be calibrated and configured with the system. Final touches are usually making sure the solar beacons are working so nobody runs into them, which happens sometimes. This is an example of one of our larger systems, well, both of our large systems, the Atwater and Green Bay. So this is the electronic stack that goes inside of that dry data well. In here, you can see this little blue inertial wave sensor. So wave height, wave direction, and wave period. Each large system that I use has a temperature sensor on it, and that's, again, usually the public favorite because the fishermen want to know where in the water column they should expect to find their next big fish. So people love the temperature sensors. Temperature profile just shows every meter or every 2 meters, depending on the system, obviously the temperature down to the bottom, wherever it's deployed. So this goes usually on the majority of our systems, we use sondes at the surface or about a meter down. So temperature conductivity, pH, turbidity or water clarity, dissolved oxygen, total algae, so chlorophyll and blue-green algae or phycocyanin. But every year things change. We tweak parameters here and there, so I just need to go in and make sure that every sensor is set up to communicate effectively, appropriately with the data logger that we have set up. Mashing a lot of third-party sensors together and make sure that they play well with each other. And yeah, just making sure everything is working in the lab for at least a few weeks before we put it out, because it's never fun when you put it out and something's not working. Weather for spring. It's a little choppy, but it's not terrible. So once we get on station, we're gonna anchor. We've got another boat that's already at the station. They're gonna pull the anchor lines up. Once they have those secured, we're gonna send a line over with the buoy, and they'll pull it in, attach the two chains, drop the temperature string, and we should be good to go. We're trying to see if Harvey's putting on his diving gear. If he is, that means they weren't able to pull the chains up with the winch. I don't see any chain yet. Now they're yanking on it. Still possible he might have to get in the water. They're anchoring like on the side too, which makes it worse. Oh, I see chain. That's a good sign. Now hopefully they can find the ends of the chain. And then Harvey won't have to get in the water. Looks pretty miserable over there. The most obvious benefit, the greatest benefit of the buoy is that it's a public service piece of equipment. So local people can check weather data, wave data, to make sure it's safe to go out on the lake. So it's a very widely used tool, and it's very valuable for the community. A lot of standing around and looking at the chain. I don't know if we're going to be able to find the ends of the chain. I think they've got one done. They're still working on the other one. Well, that is the other one. It looks like two of the ends are kind of flapping, so I think he did it.
Are we plopping before they're ready? Because it can just sit over here.
We're pretty up and down. I'd say we probably don't want this on the side. It should wait.
Aft hydraulics, I'll take up on the winch a little bit. We can lose all the tie downs and the back aft gate. And then we'll be ready.
Let the wind take her. Not bad. Nice job, Matt.
All right, so just need a hand. Trying to stabilize this. I'll
yeah.
Get in the water as fast as I can. And then get the hooks off.
Yep.
You're up.
Now, here's hoping they put the camera the right way. It went really well. They were able to pull up the chains. Harvey didn't have to get in the water. Once we got it in, we unhooked it, and it's their problem now.
There you go.
Woo! We're hearing laughter. That's always a good thing. It's done. Good job. Sorry, Karen. I owe you a puppy. Thank you, guys. No, never. Not mine.
Jesse, is this the earliest we've ever got it out?
It might be, yeah. Oh, it's a beautiful thing. So we're already live on Seagull, which is where anyone can find the data. Last data point was from 41 minutes ago, so it should be updating pretty soon here. And everything looks good. So hooray for that. Today went really well. Everything is working smoothly. So this was the first one for the season, which is always really exciting. And I've got four more to go. So I've got a couple more that I need to get ready. Every time we send a buoy off, I've worked on it for months beforehand. The moment it's off the back deck, it's just like, okay, have a good day at school. Like, put all this work into it and just hope that it survives for the season. And I didn't even break a nail, and I'm not bleeding. So it went great.